cannolis. If you've had them once, you've spent a lot of money having them again and again. Today I'm sharing two simple ways to make these, deep fried and air fried. And no, they're not the same recipes. After failing to find out the exact oil absorption for these deep fried shells from my web searches, I resolved to find out on my own to tweak the air fried recipe. The same portion of dough will come out looking quite different, but I promise this air-fried dough will actually taste like the crispy short crust you expect from cannoli shells. Start by draining your ricotta. I find these tofu press to be excellent for quick draining, for store-bought and homemade cheese. The strong spring can provide up to 10 kg of pressure, which saves you extended draining time. Counterintuitive tip, buy store-brand ricotta. The major national brands tend to have xanthan gum, guar gum, and other stabilizers added. These stabilizers make the cheese hold on to water and harder to drain. Store brand, on the other hand, often have just milk, vinegar, and salt. Simple ingredients make the cheese easier to drain. Press down on the spring and set the ricotta aside. It will be drained when you are done with the shells. 1 cup of all-purpose flour, 1 tablespoon sugar, 1/4 teaspoon salt. Whisk together and add your fat. Lard is traditional, but not everyone loves it in desserts. Coconut oil yields a very similar texture. Try unrefined virgin oil if you enjoy that lovely coconut flavor. Otherwise, refined coconut oil is completely taste-free and works great in desserts. Use 1 tablespoon for each cup of flour if you're deep frying. Roughly cut the fat into the flour and mix it in evenly with your hand until you have a coarse crumble meal. Then add your wet ingredients, which is best mixed together ahead. Separate 1 egg yolk from the egg white. Save the egg white for sealing the dough later. To the yolk, add 2 tablespoons of Marsala wine. One tablespoon of white wine vinegar. And whisk until combined. Add the yolk mixture to the dry ingredients. Stir together with a fork first so the wet ingredients won't stick to your hand too much. Then dig in once you have large dry lumps. Press to form a dough. Wrap it up and let it rest for 15 minutes so it'll be easier to roll out. In the meanwhile, make your filling. Your ricotta should be fairly drained after pressing for 10 to 15 minutes. If you don't want to bother draining ricotta, farmer's cheese is a great alternative. It's already firm and dry and mildly tart, which is great if you like adding lemon or orange zest to your fillings. The milder ricotta is more traditional and requires only powdered sugar for the base recipe. I'm using a 1/3 cup for a 15-ounce tub of ricotta. I'm also adding an 1/8 teaspoon of cinnamon. Feel free to double or omit to taste. I started with a hand mixer and quickly learned that whisk attachment don't cut into the curds well. A stick blender is much better. For best results, use a food processor or blender. You're gonna want something with a blade for that smooth, creamy texture. I'm adding an optional 1/2 cup of mini chocolate chips. You can also just fill with plain sweetened ricotta and dip the cannoli ends with chocolate chips later. Now roll out the rested cannoli dough. Feel free to use a rolling pin. I'm using a pasta attachment for consistency, because I wanted to see a side-by-side comparison between air-fried and deep-fried dough. I wanted to make sure the shells are the exact same thickness before cooking. On a scale of 1 to 8 from the pasta press, I went all the way down to level 2, which is very thin that you can see your fingers through the dough. Cut the dough with a cake ring. Use a ring cutter about 4 to 5 inches in diameter. You'll need some metal cannoli tubes. Wrap a dough sheet around the cannoli tube. Brush the end with some egg white. the dough will expand in hot oil and fall apart easily if not securely sealed. Egg white is the best glue here, much better than flour or starch water. I learned that with a lot of failed batches. Just press the ends together nice and tight and they're ready to fry. Freeze the leftover egg whites for macarons or meringues. I'm weighing the oil in the fryer before and after frying to test the oil absorption by cannoli shells. I got this fryer with a rack and drainer that will drain the residual oil back into the pot for more accurate measurement. Heat the oil to about 190 Celsius or 375 Fahrenheit and drop in the cannoli. Do not crowd the pot. Fry until puffed and golden. I rested the shells on the rack for a bit to let the excess oil drain. I didn't bother greasing the metal tubes. These pulled out easily. After frying all the shells, I cut the scraps into cannoli chips using a ravioli cutter. Not just because I have trouble wasting perfectly edible dough, but because I wanted a better idea of oil absorption for the given weight of the dough. By the way, these cannoli chips tasted amazing. I mean, look at them. Who would throw these away? Please use up the scrap dough, even if they're not pretty. These shells cool off pretty fast. Fill both ends with ricotta and they're ready to serve. Notice how thick the shells are, even from the paper-thin raw dough. This is the biggest perk of deep frying. Air-fried dough will look neater, but not nearly as puffy. I weigh the oil in the fryer after frying. The difference is about 40 grams before and after. So I increase the fat content accordingly for the air fryer recipe. Same flour, sugar, and salt. I tripled the coconut oil amount and repeated the same rest of the steps for the dough. Here are the shells just before air frying. I used the same temperature as deep frying, about 375 Fahrenheit, for 4-6 minutes. And here they are after air frying. Once they start to darken, they burn easily, so keep an eye on them, as every air fryer is a little different. Air fried shells are much easier to unmold after they cool down. Just lightly tap the ends to loosen. I've tried two patches, both greasing the tube and not greasing the tube. Same ease of removal as long as you let them cool. Here's the side by side. These shells are rolled into the exact same thickness and cut with the same ring cutter just before cooking. I thought it was interesting how different they looked, a lot more than I expected. The air-fried one had a good snap, with the flavor and texture of a short crust. It did not taste like settling. While subtly different, both are really worth making. I hope this video is helpful to anyone curious about how air-fried and deep-fried cannolis compare. Like and subscribe for more kitchen experiments and workday recipes.